Hi friends, welcome to Vidyascooking. Today I'm going to be showing you how to prepare Capsicum Bath. This is a famous recipe prepared here in Karnataka and in South basically. So we use a special Vangi Bhath masala to prepare this Capsicum Bath. All the ingredients are laid out for the masala powder. I'm going to show you from the masala powder. So to prepare this Vangi Bhath masala powder, I have laid out cinnamon, cloves, fennel, black cardamom, maize. We need sesame seeds, black gram dal, methi, star anise. We also need peppercorns. Then we need some garlic, cardamom, dry coconut, chickpeas, cumin and bay leaves. I'll also be using red chilies. You can use red chili powder if you don't have whole red chilies, and coriander powder. All these ingredients used in this recipe will be listed in the description box below this video along with measurements. Or you can also click the icon above this video which will direct you to my blog. In the blog I've got a detailed recipe along with all the ingredients listed. So don't worry, I've posted all the measurements and a detailed recipe on my blog as well. So I've heated a wok on medium flame. I've dry roasted all the ingredients just because it will grind easier. So we need to dry roast it on slow flame. Don't put it on a high flame because all the ingredients might burn. Gently keep turning it and fry it till you get a good aroma. Once the sesame seeds roast, it will splutter. That is when all your ingredients are nicely cooked. So once the sesame seeds splutters, removed from the flame and add it to a mixer jar. You can allow this to cool or you can grind it right away. If you're going to store this for a longer period of time, I would suggest allow this masala powder to cool and then put it in a bottle and store it. I've ground it into a smooth powder. The masala powder is ready. Now I've laid out all the ingredients for the capsicum bath. I'm using three colors capsicum for this recipe. I've cut it into nice cubes and I've reserved. We need cooked rice, onion, chilies and curry leaves. Onion is finely chopped, chilies are slit. We also require bay leaf, cumin, cloves, cardamom and cinnamon. Apart from that, the masala powder I prepared. We also require a little bit of turmeric powder, coriander powder and chili powder. I am using frozen peas here. It's up to you. You want to use frozen peas, you can use it or leave it out. And ginger and garlic paste, just regular ginger and garlic paste. So all these ingredients I'm going to fry one at a time. I've heated a heavy bottom pan and I've added oil. Now you need a little extra oil for this recipe. So once the oil heats up, I've added the spices. I love the spices to splutter. And I've started to add the finely chopped onion, curry leaves, chilies and ginger and garlic paste. I'm going to fry all the ingredients till the onion turns transparent. Also like me and follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter, friends. All my social media handle links will also be in the description box below this video. The same recipes are also translated and posted in YouTube Tamil. YouTube Tamil link will also be in the description box below this video. Now I've added the peas, turmeric powder, chili powder and coriander powder. Since it's frozen peas, I need to cook that. So I've added roughly about a cup of water and I'm going to allow this peas to cook first. So once the peas soften, then I'll add the capsicum and I'll start cooking along with the masala powder that I prepared. So let this peas cook and all that moisture evaporate. So once the peas has cooked and all the moisture has evaporated, I've added the capsicum. Now the capsicum, I've cut it into bite-sized pieces. I've removed all the seeds. So don't add any seeds. It's not good for you. And I've added salt as per taste. I'll fry the capsicum. You need not add any water to this. The capsicum itself contains a lot of moisture. So just allow that to cook for roughly about a minute's time. So I've allowed it to cook for a minute's time. It's released a lot of moisture. Place it on high flame and allow all this excess moisture to evaporate. This is a very nice and traditional recipe that we prepare, especially during winter. We get a lot of capsicum and a lot of English vegetables. So that is when we prepare all such recipes. It is very nice, and all the spices literally heal your body if you have any flu or cold. Now I've added the masala powder to the capsicum once all the moisture has reduced. I've added roughly about 2 tablespoons of masala powder, and I've fried the capsicum. So all these spices literally heal your body, and if you have any high fever or temperature, it reduces. So once the oil separates from the masala, that is when I'll add the cooked rice and mix it thoroughly. Now once the capsicum has nicely cooked and the oil has separated, I've added the rice, mixed it thoroughly. You need to add a half a lime juice, squeezed, freshly squeezed lime juice, and mix it thoroughly and serve it up. That's it, friends. My capsicum bath is ready. I've gone ahead and served it. It tasted excellent. Do give this recipe a try. The detailed recipe will be on my blog. All the links to my social media and blog will be in the description box below this video. If you enjoyed watching this video recipe, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to me for more recipes. I'll be seeing you soon with the next recipe video. This is Vidya Lakshmi. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.